I'm Chelsea Wood. I'm a parasite ecologist, and I study the ecology of the human disease schistosomiasis. So schisto is a trematode parasite. It's a flatworm, and it lives inside the human circulatory system. And it needs two hosts in order to complete its life cycle, people and snails. So it lives in the blood vessels of people. There, it produces eggs. Those eggs are passed out of the body in urine or feces, and then they go into natural freshwater bodies like streams or rivers or lakes. The snails then incubate the parasite, and they just pump out millions of clones of this parasite, and they penetrate the skin of people who are bathing in those freshwater bodies. What you wind up seeing in patients who've been infected for a long period of time with a large number of worms is abdominal pain and distension, and ultimately bladder cancer or liver cancer. It's awful. Our study was trying to identify ways to find heavily infected villages that would be easier than going out and diagnosing people. It's a difficult and time-consuming and labor-intensive process. And one of our easier ways was to actually count the snails that are present at a site. The more snails, the more potential schisto, the more transmission risk. You're working in super hot conditions. The water around you is infested with schistosome cercaria, and so the technicians who are doing that sampling can't touch the water. We also flew drones over each of our villages and estimated the amount of area covered by the habitat that the snails really love to hang out in, which are these particular species of floating vegetation. And you'll see that it's a different color, dark green, sometimes brownish. And so what we actually found was that it was way more accurate to use the drone images than it was to actually use counts of snails. These aerial images provided a much better proxy for where humans were infected than the very labor and time intensive snail data provided. And that's a huge benefit because it means that rather than actually traveling out to those villages to test human urine, they can do a quick drone flyover or download some satellite imagery and immediately see what the transmission risk is for a variety of villages, even ones that are really remote. Well, our hope is that this work doesn't stop with schistosomiasis, but that we can be part of the growing community of ecologists who are working to contribute our knowledge to an understanding of how to better manage and control neglected tropical diseases.